Namaste viewers, hearty welcome to Biology English. Today's our topic is B forms. Is, am, are, was, were, be, being, been. So being is the last topic that we have in this B forms. The meaning of being is I am being, nenu unnanu. We are being, memu unnamu. You are being, meeru unnaru. He is being, atanu unnadu. She is being, ame unnadi. It is being, adi unnadi. Or unnavi. They are being, varu unnaru. That will be the meaning. So here we have be, different uses are there. So we can use this being along with being plus adjective. And second, being we can use in the meaning of getting or turning. Third use, being plus V3, this is nothing but a passive form in a present and past tense. Present continuous tense and past continuous tense. In a passive voice, we use this being. Then fourth use is participle clause of being. Participle clause. So clause means a part of a sentence, a group of words giving some meaning is called a clause. So participle clauses we have. So participle means here present participle like ing form. So being, that is a participle. And a clause being a friend, it is a clause. Being a friend is a clause. So like that we will discuss in detail about participle clauses in the next upcoming videos. And the fifth use is being as a gerund. So gerund means it is a noun cum verb form. So we can use the gerund in the form of a verb, or we can use in the form of a noun. In the place of subject we can use, in the place of object we can use. So these are the main uses of this being. And now let's just go in detail with examples. So first one, being plus adjective. So I am being kind, we are being kind, you are being kind, he is being kind, she is being kind, they are being kind. Adjective we have to use, kind, you are being nice, or they are being polite, they are being good, they are being generous, you are being lazy these days, you are being lazy and nu lazy ga unnavu. He is being lazy, atanu lazy ga unnadu. She is being lazy, ame lazy ga unnadi. They are being lazy, vallu lazy ga unnaru. So you are being generous, no, generous, generous means freely giving. You are being good, no, manchiga unnavu. They are being good. So after being we have to use adjectives. So these all are adjectives. So being is used before the adjective. That is the first use. And the second use is be we use in the meaning of getting or turning. Ramana is getting selfish, or we can say other way, Ramana is being selfish. Just first meaning only, being. In the place of being, we are using getting or turning. Ramana is being selfish. Ramana is getting late. Ramana is being late. She is getting strong. So she was so weak. She is getting strong. Ama balanga tayaravutu unnadi. Unnadi. She is getting strong. Or she is being strong. Ama stronger unnadi. I will be turning 36 years next year. Next year, naaku 36 years. I will be turning. And 36 leki ellabothunna ani cheppadaniki turning. I will be turning 36 years. You will be getting slim. No, slim ga tayaravutho. You will be turning slim, or you will be getting slim. So you are being slim. So future tense and we cannot use. We can use in the present or past tense. We can use this be. This is the second use. And third rule is being plus V3. So it's nothing but a passive form that is in a present continuous and past continuous. Let's take one example. Kasimi being sent. Kasim is being sent by his brother. Kasim is being sent to school by his parents. Kasim school ko pampinchabaddadu, pampinchabadutunnadu. He is being sent. Amruta was being, this is a is, it is a present continuous tense. Amruta was being called by mother. Amruta, mother cheta pilavabadutu undenu. Past continuous tense, present continuous tense. Food is being cooked. They are, chef is cooking the food. Chef is cooking the food. And passive tense, food is being cooked by chef. So, like this, in a passive form, we are going to use this being. And the fourth rule, participle clause. So, let us see what is a participle clause. So, participle means ing form. Verb plus ing form is called a participle. So, here be plus ing, being a teacher. Being a teacher, it is a clause. It is a part of a sentence. Clause is nothing but group of words. And it is a part of a sentence and it will have a verb in it and it gives some meaning but not complete meaning. So here if you take being a teacher, so this is a not giving complete meaning, it's giving some meaning, so it's called a clause. Whatever clause it is, participle clause. So since it's started with ing form, it's called a participle clause. Next, being a friend, I called him. Being a friend, I called him. So being a friend, being a teacher, it's my responsibility to correct the students. Being a neighbor, I should help them. Being a elder person in the family, I should bear the responsibilities. So being ante undatam valana, kavatam valana anedi. Kavatam valana ante it is not giving meaning, so it's a part of a sentence, so it is called clause. So in a participle clauses we use this being. And the last one we have being. Being, we use it as a gerund. Gerund means we can use, it is a noun and a verbal form it will have. Walking. Walking is my hobby. Walking is the gerund. I like walking. Walking. Here, subject place we can use, in the object place we can use. So walk is the verb, but if you are adding ing, it becomes gerund. Walking. Walking is my hobby. Walking is my hobby. And walking becomes noun. I am walking. I am walking. And walking will be verb. So verbal noun this is. Gerund is nothing but a verbal noun. It will have verb form and it will have noun form. So here, being selfish. Being selfish. It is a gerund is not good. Being kind is good. Being winner is appreciated. Being early to school is a good habit. Being early. So this is the being came in the form of a, in the place of a subject. So this is called gerund, being. Being late is his habit. Being late to school is his habit. Late ga raavadam atani habit. So here in both the places we are using this being in the form of a subject. If you take next, they enjoy being with their teacher. They enjoy, after verb there it came, enjoy being. Here it is in the objective case. In the objective place it has come. So in the subjective place we can use, in the objective case we can use this gerund. They enjoy being with the teacher. I love being in Goa. Being in Goa. So here we are using in the objective place. So the gerund can be used in the subjective place or objective place. So in this way we have this being different uses. And I think some advanced level I have gone this in this be forms. Is a marvelous verb, being, these all. Some advanced, maybe intermediate like that topics are included in this. From different sources I have collected. Even if you don't understand all the topics, no problem. You don't worry about the basics. But whatever you understand, the basic concepts you understand, that's enough. You need not to buy out all these five rules or five things, five uses. No. Whatever you understand, that you keep in your mind, that's fine, and keep on practicing your own sentences with the is, am, are, was, were, be, been, being. So next we are going to discuss do forms, do, does, did, and then we'll be followed with the have forms, have, has, had, and then we'll go with the modal verbs. So please be in touch with the Biology English channel and keep on sharing and keep on liking my videos and introducing to your near and dear ones. Thank you.
Okay.